So our lesson for today is all about multiplication of radical. So in multiplication of radical, the product of nth root of two numbers is equal to the nth root of the product of those number. Or in symbol, we have nth root of A multiplied by nth root of B is equal to nth root of AB. So as you can see, just only multiplying the two radicand, then we already get the product. Like for example, okay, we have square root of 3 multiplied by square root of 2. So if we multiply this one, is equal to 3 multiplied by 2, that will be 6, or simply square root of 6. So that is how we multiply a radical. Remember that when you multiply a radical, they should have a same order, or like for example, it is a square root, then it will multiply only for the square root. They supposed to be similar in order before you multiply. Okay, let's have another one. We have cube root of 5 multiplied by cube root of 2. So when you multiply this one, the result will be cube root of 5 multiplied by 2, that will be 10. So the answer is cube root of 10. Okay, let's have another example. We have fourth root of 2 multiplied by fourth root of 8 is equal to, still just copy the order or the fourth root, then multiply the radicand. So we have 2 times 8, that will be 16. Can we simplify 4th root of 16? Yes, we can simplify that one. So the result will be 16 is a perfect 4th root, so that will be 2. How do I get 2? Okay, so we have 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. So when you multiply this one, so we have 2 times 2, that will be 4. 4 times 2, that will be 8. 8 times 2, that will be 16. So therefore, 16 is a perfect fourth root. So the answer is 2. Okay, so notice that when you multiply, make sure they are the same in order. Like for example, this is square root, and it will just only multiply also in a square root. Another example is the cube root. So if we just only multiplying similar order, we just only multiplying cube root to cube root, fourth root to fourth root. Okay, can you follow? Next, let's have an example. Okay, we have example number 1. We have 3 square root of 2 multiplied by square root of 6. Okay. Try to see if the two radicand is in the same order. So as you can see, they are square root. So we can now proceed to multiplication. Okay, so we have 3 square root of 2 multiplied by 1 square root of 6. Where do I get 1? Automatically there is a 1 here, so they remove it, so I just only rewrite it so to be able you to see the way we multiply. So let's have 3 multiplied by 1, that will be 3. Then square root of 2 multiplied by square root of 6 is square root of 12. Okay, since 12 can be simplified, Okay, so let's factor out that one. So this will be square root of. Okay, what think two number that the result is 12. So, and what do you call that? The two factors, one of them is a perfect square. So let's have the factors of 12. So we have 2 times 6, that will be 12. How about 4 times 3? That will be also 12. So where is the two factor that what do you call that, which have a perfect square, and which has a one of them is a perfect square? Can we use this one? Is 2 is a perfect square? No. Is 6 is a perfect square? No. Therefore, let's have this one. We have, is 4 is a perfect square? Yes. What about 3? No. That's not a perfect square. So therefore, based on our process of what do you call that, and simplifying a radical and in factoring, one of them should be a perfect square. So the factor that we need is this one, 4 times 3. So we have 4 times 3. So when you multiply that one, that will be 12, and one of them is a perfect square and one of them is not. So based on our factorization and simplification of the radical, one of them should be a perfect square and one of them is not. So the factor is 4 times 3. So we simplify that one, so it will be 3. So it, since it 4 is a perfect square, that will be, what is the square root of 4? That will be 2 multiplied by 2. It will be written outside. Then square root of, since 3 is not a perfect square, then we will write inside of the radical sign. Then proceed to multiplication this one. So we have 3 times 2, that will be 6. Then we have square root of 3. So that is now the answer, or that is the product of the example number 1, which is 3 square root of 2 multiplied by square root of 6. Okay, so may we have example number 2. Okay, this is the example number 2. Okay, so we have example number 2 is equal, example number 2 is 3 multiplied by square root of 3 plus square root of 12. As you can see, there is a close open parenthesis, meaning we will distribute 3 inside of the close open parenthesis. So we have, let's write again, so we have 3 square root of 3 plus square root of 12. Okay, so let's distribute this one inside. So we have 3 multiplied by 1, that will be 3 multiplied by 1, that will be 3 square root of 3. Next, 3 multiplied by 1, that will be plus 3 square root of 12. Okay, there is what they call that, a visible one there. Okay, so we have 3 square root of 3 plus 3 square root of 12. Next, since 12 can be 12 can be simplified, and let's simplify that one, so it become 3 square root of 3 plus 3 square root of, okay, let's factor this one, 12. What's the factor of 12? We have 4 times 3. Okay, so in factoring, remember one of them will be a perfect square. So we have 4 multiplied by 3, that will be 12. Okay, so we have 3 square root of 3 plus, okay, so we have 3. Okay, what is the square root of 4? So we have 2. Okay, since 3 is not a perfect square, then it remains inside of the radical sign. So that will be square root of 3. Then simplify, we have 3 square root of 3 plus 3 times 2, that will be 6 square root of 3. Okay, can we add this one? Yes, they can they will be add, because they are same order and same radical. So we have just add the what they call that the numbers outside. So we have 3 plus 6, that will be 9. Then copy the radical, or what they call that, the square root of 3. So we have square root of 3. So that is now the answer. Okay, so may we have example number 3. Okay, so the given example number 3 is 2 square root of x times 5 square root of 6x times square root of 2x. So in multiplying, remember, see to it, all the radical is in the same order. So as you can see, they are all in square root. Then we will now proceed to multiplication. Then let's write first the given. We have 2 square root of x multiplied by 5 square root of 6x multiplied by square root of 2x. Okay, I will write the invisible one there. Okay. Okay, so let's multiply first the outside number, or the outside of the radical. So we multiply this one, 2 multiplied by 5, that will be 10, times 1, still that will be 10. Okay, next, let's multiply also the radicand, the values of the radicand, the radicand. We have x multiplied by, or let's say that this is 1. Okay, 1 multiplied by 6, that will be still 6. Times 2, that will be 12. So we have square root of 12. Then let's multiply also the variable. So we have x times x, that is still that will be x square. Then x times x square times x, that will be x cube. Okay, how do we get the x cube? Okay, so in exponent, okay, so let's say this one, x, 1, x raised to 1. Okay, so in multiplying what they call that, if you multiply this one, the radical, the exponent will be add. So that will be x, x plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. So the result will be x. So that will be the answer. So we have 10 square root of 12 square root of 12x cube. Okay, since 12x cube can be simplified, okay, so let's factor that one. Okay, we have, okay, so we factor the radicand with respect to the square root. So the factor of 12 is 4 times 3. Okay, so we have with respect to the square root. So remember, when getting the factor of the 12, make sure that one of them is a perfect square, and 4 is a perfect square, and 1 and 3 is not a perfect square. Then let's factor x cube with respect to the x square. So we have multiplied by x, I said x cubed. So x squared multiplied by x. Okay, as I said a while ago, if you multiply this one, okay, the exponent will be add. So there is an, what do you call that, invisible one there. So the 2, the exponent will be add. So that will be 2 plus 1, that will result to x cubed. Okay. Okay, let's simplify this one. So we have 10. Okay, square root of 4 is 2. So it will multiply outside. So it become, and written outside, we have 2. Then we have square root of, okay, since 3 is not a perfect square, then it remain inside of the radical. Okay, then we have x square that will be written outside, it become x. Okay, how it become x? Okay, since what they call that, the radical sign have a value of exponent as 1/2, then it will multiply to x square. Okay, so it result to 2 multiplied by 1, that will be 2 divided by 2, a result to 1. So we have x square, I know x, let's say. Then since x is not a perfect square, then it will return inside of the radical. Okay, so let's get the product of this one. So we have 10 times 2, that will be 20, times x, that will be 20x. Then copy square root of 3. So that is now the answer. Okay, may we have example number 4? Okay, so we have here example number 4. Okay, so it involves a open close parenthesis, meaning it will multiply. Okay, so we have square root of 2 plus square root of 3 multiplied by square root of 2, square root multiplied by 4 square root of 2 minus square root of 3. Okay. So in multiplying this one, just only multiplying a two-digit number. Like for example, okay, let's have one example. Okay, we have this one. Okay, so it's just only multiplying a two-digit number. Like for example, the process of this one, when you multiply this one, this is how they multiply. You can also use the FOIL method. Okay, so let's have one example. Let's aside muna yan. Okay, did muna natin yan. Okay, so we have example, we have 14 times 12. Okay, if you multiply this one, this will be the start, isn't it? So we have 2 times, let's see. Okay, 2 times 4. Okay, 2 times 4, that will be if, then followed by this order. Okay, 2 times 1, that will be 2, and followed by this one, that will be, okay, that will be 1 times 4, that will be 4, and it will be written here, isn't it? Then 1 multiplied by 1, that will be still 1. Then it will proceed to addition. So we have 8, 6, 2 plus 4, that will be 6, bring down 1. So this process is the same process with the example number 4. Okay, remember the process of this one, because that is the process that we will do in this example number 4. Okay, so remember this one. Okay, remember the okay, so let me, we have this one. Okay, so we have, we write this one in this manner. Okay, so we have square root of 2 plus square root of 3 multiplied by, we have 4 square root of 2 minus square root of 3. Okay. So the answer will be, okay, same process. Okay, it will start this part. So when you multiply, okay, so as you can see, they are the same in order, so we can multiply. Okay, so we have square root of 3 times square root of 3. The result will be square root of 9. 3 times 3, that will be 9. Then copy the radical sign, which is square root. Then negative multiply by negative, negative multiply by positive, and result will be negative. Next, we will multiply this one. Okay, so negative multiplied by positive is still negative. And multiply this one. Okay, 3 multiplied by 2, that will be 6, or square root of 6. Then, negative, as I said a while ago, negative multiplied by positive here. There is a positive there. Negative multiplied by positive, that result to what? Okay, that will result to negative. Okay, so we have, okay, so since we're already done with this process, and this one, okay, now we will multiply this part. Okay, 4, okay, let's start with the radical first. So we have 2 multiplied by 3, that will be, okay, I will align here, we have square root of 6. 2 multiplied by 3, that will be 6, positive 6. Then, since there is invisible 1 there, 4 multiplied by 1, that's the answer will be 4. Then, since we're already done on that part, so we multiply, we proceed this one. Okay, so 2 times 2, that will be 4. Or simply, it's positive. Okay, since 2 times 2, that will be positive square root of 4. So we have square root of 4. Then, since there is invisible 1 there, we have, okay, 4 times 1, that will be 4. Then proceed to addition as I've done a while ago in this example. So then we will add. Okay, bring down negative square root of 9. Then, since there is invisible one there, then okay, there is invisible one there, so the result will be, okay, plus, okay, so it will be proceed to subtraction, because they are what they call that, different in sign, and the operation is addition, and this will be proceed to subtraction. So we have 3, then copy square root of 6, then bring down 4 square root of 4. So this is now the product of this one. So we have 4 square root of, okay, 4 square root of 4 plus 3 square root of 6 minus square root of 9. Okay, so this is the product of this one. Okay, so let's simplify this one. Okay, so 4, since 4 is a perfect square, Okay, it will be written 2 square root of 4 is multiplied by 2 plus. Okay, since 6 is not a perfect square, so therefore it remains 3 square root of 6 minus. There are perfect since 9 is a perfect square and the square root of 9 is, okay, so the square root of 9 is 3. Okay, so let's multiply this one, so the answer will be 8 plus square root of 6 minus 3. Okay, so combine like terms, we just only add and subtract those similar term, which is this one is a similar term, so we can subtract that one, so the result will be 8 minus 3, okay, I just only arrange it, plus square root of 3 square root of 6. Okay, so let's subtract that one, the result will be, okay, so the result will be 5 plus 3 square root of 6. So that is now the answer. Okay, may we have example number 5? Example number 5 is 2 plus square root of 3 square. If you encounter a square, meaning to say it multiplied itself, so this will be written as 2 plus square root of 3 multiplied by 2 plus square root of 3. Okay, so that is the this is the outcome of the 2x 2 plus square root of 3. Okay, so as you can see, it is similar from the example number 4. So, similar in such a way that the, close open, it involves a close open parenthesis. So, same process that we will do on the, example number 4. So, you can use a FOIL method if you are good in FOIL method. But for now, I will use the vertical way that we've done a while ago. Okay, so I will write it in vertical way. So we have 2 plus square root of 3. 2 plus square root of 3. This will be multiplication. Then, as we do a while ago, this will be the first one. So, okay, so we have square root of 3 multiplied by square root of 3. That will be square root of 9. Okay, then positive multiplied by positive, that will be still positive. Then we will proceed here. Okay, so we have 1 multiplied by 2. There is an invisible 1 here. So we have 1 multiplied by 2, that will be 2. Then copy square root of 3. Next one. So 2 multiplied by 1, there is still be invisible 1 there. We have 2 multiplied by 1, that will be 2, then copy square root of 3. Next, we have then this one, 2 times 2, that will be, okay, that will be 4. So we have here kanina, a while ago, we have a positive, so that will be positive. Okay, this one, positive. So we have 2 multiplied by 1, is still a positive. 2 then square root of 3, so plus, so we will proceed to addition. So we have bring down square root of 9, bring down positive, then plus, so we have 2 plus 2, that will be 4, then copy square root of 3. Okay, can you follow? Next, bring down 4. So this is now the, okay, product of this one. Okay, so actually this is the supposed to be
This is the just only the process. This is only the process. No need to write this one. Okay, but okay. So supposed to be this. This will be the second step here. Supposed to be this one. So we have the 4 plus 4 square root of 3 plus square root of 9. Okay, so we have, okay, let's simplify things that we need to simplify. As you can see, 9 can be simplified. Okay, so we have 4 plus 4 square root of 3 plus square root of 9 is 3. So we have, we need now to combine like terms, find the terms that is similar. So we have 4 and 3, that is similar term. So we can add that one. Okay, I'll just arrange it. 4 plus 3 plus 4 square root of 3. Okay, I just only arranging. Okay, so then proceed to addition. We have 4 plus 3, that will be 7. That will be 7. Then plus 4 square root of 3. Why we will not add this one? Okay, because they are not similar terms, so we cannot add this one. So that is now the answer.
For more videos on mathematics, please don't forget to subscribe.